our host, John Denver.
John? John Denver?
Hiya, Bruce.
How are you doing? You're a very impressive team you have this year.
Yes, I noticed that. I think we have a good shot at taking home the cake.
That's really important. You know, last year your team got sixth place. It was a little embarrassing.
You didn't have to bring that up.
Yeah, well, but this year I know it's going to change. I know it's going to change because I heard that you changed the rules around so that your team could have the advantage. Is there any truth to that?
That is not true. I did not change the rules. First of all, there are no rules. Basically, what we have is one pro on each team with several celebrities. Mm-hmm. We race against each other through the day. The two teams with the most accumulated victories at the end of the day will pair off in the finals, and you'll see us there.
You got the right attitude.
Did
you?
All right.
What are you going to say? In this race, John Denver will race on the red course versus George Hamilton on the blue course, Bruce. And I might add, they both reside in Aspen, Colorado. They get a lot of chance to do recreational skiing.
But this is a little bit different than recreational skiing. As John Denver comes out of the gates very well, George Hamilton looks like he's improved this year. He's looking tough. And it's Denver out in the lead. Very aggressive as George Hamilton is pushing for all he's worth, but it's going to be John Denver as George Hamilton goes down. John Denver's our winner. George Hamilton desperately trying to put his skis back on as John Denver celebrates the victory.
The legs.
The legs. His
legs.
Right. Come on here, George. Come on. What happened up there?
Age.
Age got to you, huh?
Yes, no, I was worried about his age.
My age? Yes. Yeah, I appreciate that,
no,
George.
I was worried about it because I didn't want to hurt him, and I decided I was getting awfully close, so I just had to lie down. It was, you know how it goes.
That's the admirable
thing. You know something? His time was so incredible. I watched it, you know, and I said to myself, there's no way I'll be matched up against because he's got an 18-something time. Best I ever had was 1919. That was the year. I couldn't believe it. And he's just a terrific skier. He's got
he is pretty tough.
And you know what we got? We got a letter.
I don't have nearly the experience that you do, George.
Well, love life has nothing to do with John.
We better quit on that one, guys.
I have a little friend here from last year's tournament I want to talk to. Hiya, Julie. Welcome back. Who's your partner?
Jamie, my sister.
Is that right? Hiya, Jamie.
Hi.
You know, if you get a couple more people, you could be in the races.
We'll also beat you next year.
Well, who are you going to get to beat me?
Zachary and Anna Kate.
My Zach and Anna Kate?
Yes.
That'd be great. Well, I look forward to that. Tell them we'll be right back.
We'll be right back.
Yo. Thanks, you guys. My wife Annie and I are having a good time out here in the mountains, as is, I think, everybody. You know, being out here like this, smelling the pine trees and looking out at that beautiful lake over there. It's one of the things I enjoy so much about skiing, is being able to get outside like this in the wintertime. There's some kids from Houston, Texas who feel very much the same way. And I really think there's something. They have a group they call the Sunshine Kids, and they sent us their symbol, that's Annie and I are wearing. Pins. They sent it to us because they like one of my songs, Sunshine on My Shoulders. They have a little paper they put out called the Sunshine Gazette. And I think they're very, very special young people, and Annie's going to tell you a little bit about them.
Yeah, they're really wonderful, and I think as I proceed to tell you about them, you'll agree with me.
Just announced the establishment of the Sunshine Kids Foundation in Houston. And the foundation will be responsible for assisting hospitals all over the country in setting up similar rehabilitative programs. And they've just announced the establishment of the first Sunshine Kids Winter Games to be held in March 1983 in Winter Park, Colorado.
And if we're lucky, we'll be there.
I'll say.
And that look on his face is not because of those beautiful photos, but because of just a minute ago, he had this race with Jack Ford. And Jack Ford took the lead right from the start and just dominated it. Jack Ford came up with a big victory over John Denver.
I can verify that.
Okay. Hey, John.
Thanks for
always
being
a pleasure.
Here, Bruce.
It's been a lot of years we've been doing the show now.
Yeah, I hope we can keep doing it.
Oh, I enjoy it. Last year, what you said, he said, this year I can come back and I can do absolutely anything I want, right?
That's right, yeah.
Well, life on the farm is kind of laid back, ain't nuts.
I know the old people
country boy
in the
like
South truck.
Early to rise, early in the sack.
Thank God I'm a country boy. Well, a simple kind of life never did me no harm. Raising me a family and working on the farm. Days are all filled with an easy country charm. Thank God I'm a country boy. Well, I got me a fine wife, I got me old fiddle. When the sun's coming up, I got cakes on the griddle. Life ain't nothing but a funny, funny riddle. Thank God I'm a country boy. Yeah.
Thank you.
one of them money-hungry fools. Rather have my fiddle and my thumb and tools. Thank God I'm a country boy. Yeah, city folk driving in a black limousine. A lot of sad people thinking that's a mighty keen. Son, let me tell you now exactly what I mean. I thank God I'm a country boy. Well, I wouldn't trade my life for diamonds or jewels. I never was one of them money-hungry fools. Rather have my fiddle and my thumb and tools. Thank God I'm a country boy.
Ha ha ha.